Welcome to this lesson. In this lesson, I want to cover a couple of use cases for using IAM roles. So we've used IAM roles quite a few times so far, but I want to show you a few very common situations. So let's get into it. Now, we've already configured cross-account access when we used AWS organizations, because what organizations did is it created a role for us in the new account, and then we're able to assume that role. Now, that role has full access privileges to the account, so it might be good for administrative purposes, but commonly what you'll do is you'll use a very similar situation to enable cross-account access, but the role will only provide very specific permissions. So that's what this use case is. In this example, we need a user in account B to be able to assume a role so he can access an S3 bucket in account A. So that's the only rights he's going to have, the ability to access that bucket. We assign an identity-based policy to the user, and that will allow the user to assume the role in account A. Remember, you need the privilege to run the SDS assume role API action and be able to assume the role. So he runs the API action and assumes the role in account A. And then the trust policy of the role in account A must allow the user from account B to assume the role. So you can either have this configured the way it was with the role in AWS organizations. That role allowed anybody in the other account, so it specified the account number. Or you can lock it down to, you know, specific identities. The role also needs a permissions policy. And the permissions policy will allow the role to access the bucket, to read, write objects, whatever it is you need to do. And then the user is able to access through that role the S3 bucket. The next use case is very, very similar. It's almost identical. The difference is I mentioned third party here. The reason being is if you own both accounts, that's one thing. But if you're allowing people from external, so external companies, third parties, to assume your roles, you always have to share the ARN of the role with them. And there can be some security issues with doing that. So what we do instead is we just add something to secure this connection, to make sure that only the people that we want to be able to use this shared ARN of the role and be able to assume that role are the people that we want them to be. So in this case, same thing, we have an identity-based policy allowing the user to assume the role using the shared ARN. That's the same as in the previous example. There's also a permissions policy allowing the role to access the bucket and a trust policy. Now the difference with the trust policy is, and I'll show you an example of the JSON here. You'll notice that the principal is AWS and then the third party AWS account ID. So we're only allowing people from account B. And then we have a condition. And the condition includes a string equals STS external ID. And then there's an identifier. Now you wouldn't use 12345. You'd create something complex, something only you know, and something that you're going to share secretly with account B. So this trust policy condition actually requires the external ID. And therefore, when you run the STS assume role API action, you must also supply the external ID. So that adds an extra level of security. And this is something we're actually going to practice in the hands-on. Next up, we've got delegation to AWS services. And attaching IAM roles to EC2 instances is something that we do very commonly when working with AWS. In this case, we have an EC2 instance with some kind of application running, and the application needs to access an S3 bucket. Now, I often use S3 buckets as an example, but this could be any AWS service. It could be DynamoDB, it could be RDS, it could be, you know, pretty much anything else. But the point is, the application needs to get the permissions to be able to talk to another AWS service. So how does it do that? Well, we create an instance profile. We associate an IAM role with the instance profile. EC2 then attempts to assume the role using an API call. And remember that this will have a trust policy and a permissions policy attached. Trust policy will control who assumes the role, and it will look something like this. So it will have the principal as a service, ec2.amazonaws.com, and that service is allowed to assume the role. Then STS will supply temporary credentials and the application can access the bucket. This is another use case we're going to practice in the hands-on in this section. And remember, those temporary credentials include an access key, a secret access key, a session token, and also an expiration time. And you'll see in the hands-on when we generate these, you'll actually get to see them in the flesh. So that's the theory, and in the next couple of lessons, we'll put into practice two of these use cases.